Spring band concert. This is the Basie Jazz Ensemble, and on solos we had Nijin Holman on the piano and Blade Pamperin on the flugelhorn. Let's give a warm round. This next song has a very interesting title if you looked in your program. It was written by my good friend and Winneconne alumni, Noah Harmon, and that's actually his son right there, John Harmon on the drums. And I think he wrote this song inspired by his son, maybe forgetting his music sometimes. So it's entitled, Yes, I Forgot My Music Again, Sorry, Mr. Jitterbeck. So, we're going to feature some solos on this one. Brianna Johnson on tenor, Rudy Liljeberg on guitar, Jack Hildebrand on vibraphone. Thank you. right? We're going to have a quick changeover. Let's get the Ellington Jazz Ensemble up here. Thank you. was Hayden Schultz on tenor saxophone and Jenny Williams on piano. There were a lot of soloists on that one. Ginny Williams on piano, Rudy on guitar. That was Tanner on the alto saxophone, Alex on the trumpet, and Ben on the trombone. Give it up. All right, I put these kids in a really bad position. Only probably a month ago, I gave them probably one of the toughest jazz charts I've ever given my students. And so they've only had a really about a month to learn this piece, but it's a transcription of a Buddy Rich song. If you know Buddy Rich, probably one of the greatest drummers to ever play the instrument, and had an amazing big band back in the day. But this chart really cooks, and it really challenges the saxophone section, especially. So without further ado, straight note chaser.
Thank you.
David Schultz on the tenor. Brent Bowling on the vibraphone. Jacob Thomas on the drums.
All right.
The moment you've all been waiting for. It's time for some polka music. So we're going to clear the stage and get the polka band up here. That was the Lindenau polka. And with all good polkas, you gotta complement it with a waltz. It's like ketchup and mustard. So this is our waltz song. It's a Czech number called Sakinka, but in America it was translated and made popular as the Blue Skirt Waltz. I believe it sold over 1 million records for Frankie Yankovic back in the day as well. But without this song, I probably wouldn't be here today because it was one of my grandparents' first dances and eventually led to falling in love and eventually me. So I'm really grateful for this song, so the Blue Skirt Waltz.
Thank you. I
was about 12 years overdue. That was my good friend and mentor, Lisa Zemlock. I don't know if many of you know, but she is retiring at the end of this year. So this is kind of a special concert for her, because many of these students learned under her. So I thought it's only fitting that she get a chance to direct them at this level too. So she'll be joining us in a few songs to play a trumpet song, which is a beautiful song written by former band director at Brigham High School. It's a very magnificent piece and kind of highlights the world-class musician that Mrs. Emlock is as well. On this next piece, we have one of my good friends, Noah Harmon. He's also a Winneconne alum, one of the best piano players I've ever met, and you're gonna be in for a real treat. Like, this is virtuosic level of piano playing, and honestly, I'm not kidding, and you'll see what I'm talking about, but I asked him earlier this year, I'm like, I need to find a piano player who is crazy enough to do it. He's like, yeah, sure, whatever, without even hesitating. But he's phenomenal. I'm so excited that he's joining us tonight. And he really like raised the level of the ensemble too. So without further ado, this is George Gershwin's Rhapsody in Blue.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
All right, as promised, we're going to bring out Mrs. Zemlock to be featured on a trumpet song. I'm just so impressed with these students, the maturity that they're playing with. It's definitely on par with a college ensemble or even professionals. So I'm just so thankful to be working with these students. And as you can tell, it's just pretty magical things are happening. So thank you very much for being here tonight. And without further ado, this is Trumpet Song featuring Mrs. Lisa Zemlock. Christmas. So, I need to recognize a few people. We do have an awards night I'm very, very excited about. We have some members of the band and choir councils that are organizing a special night to honor those that participated in solo ensemble and those music students that earned a letter this year. That'll be coming up in the end of May, the last Wednesday, I believe. Parents, I sent you home an email, so just double check that and you can hopefully make it that night. But tonight we have a few awards that I need to give out, band specific. I promise I'll make this as brief. I know it's been a really long concert, but I'm very proud of all the work that these students have done. I just owe them a little bit more time. I promise the kids it's going to be shorter than the Avengers movie, so it's not that long. So without further ado, I want to honor some of the younger students. So this goes to a freshman. It's called the Rookie of the Year Award. And, basically, any of these students, many of them have gone way above and beyond the expectations, but it comes down to picking one student, and I think this student has demonstrated, as far as freshmen go, just total dedication, practicing every night, learned multiple instruments this year. It goes to Meejin Homan. This student a bunch tonight as well. This goes to the most improved sophomore this year, and that is John Harmon. And our most improved junior this year is RJ Olson. This particular award doesn't happen very, very often. It probably happens maybe once every generation. And if you look at the plaque, it's in our music suite, and there's one from like the 60s, there's one from the 70s, and there's a student from the 80s, and there was one even in the 2000s. But this particular student has gone to state 5 years. It's dating back to middle school, eighth grade, 5 years in a row for a solo. This is Hayden Schultz. Why don't you come on? Alright, would all the seniors, that include seniors that are in Jazz Ensemble and Pokemon, would you please come up here? Just, if you can get in alphabetical order by last name, that would be awesome. See how good they can figure this out. Well, Caleb, you're gonna be first at least, I know that. Alright, now this is the first year we've done something like this. Typically I get the seniors a medal, and most of them are graduating now, so it's not like they're gonna use their letter jacket anymore, so I kinda had to rethink the whole medal thing. And they know me, I'm kinda sentimental, and I'm cheesy, but they know I love them a lot. So I made these plaques. Well, certificates, and kind of has your nickname, and or at least things that I find endearing about each one of you. So Caleb, he is our bass guitar hero. A few summers ago, he asked, hey, can I take a few bass lessons? He basically did 3 bass lessons, and then he was already better than me. Phenomenal. But hey, I'm putting a plug in for Guitar Hero, that video game. I think that really helped. Definitely the coordination, but he picked it up within 3 lessons and has become just an essential part of our band and the low end. So they're like, Mr. Jeremy, don't get us like participation awards, but it's mainly like putting up with me for 4 years type award. But there you go, Caleb, bass guitar hero. Uh, Yeah, you can. We'll just rotate and bring it around. This is Daniel Bieski. He's going to University of Central Florida next year on a full cheerleading scholarship. I'm sure if I asked him, he could probably pick me up with one hand right now. I mean, he's pretty phenomenal, but always like very positive person, very caring, and just always is bringing the energy to the band. So he's our energizer, and there you go, Daniel. This is Gage Cady, the band professor. You heard him, Piccolo. Phenomenal kid, and always has a fun fact, no matter what. Even if it's not fun, it's always a fun fact. And, I'm gonna really, really miss that about Gage, and so you are forever memorized or memorialized as Mr. Fun Fact. So there you go. Teresa has been a mainstay of our jazz ensembles for the past 4 years. Phenomenal student. Can't really get her to ever say much to me. She's very, very quiet, but when she plays that tenor saxophone, it has a really big sound and is always game for just playing jazz. And so she is our jazzy rocker. Thank you, Teresa. F comes before L. This is Jack Frable. Wasn't able to join us first semester this year, but came back and is just a leader in the percussion section. And for that, you're going to be the comeback kid. So thank you for coming back, Jack. This is Nathan Heenan. Reminds me a lot of myself. I was a tuba player. And Nate has been the foundation of our ensembles from jazz band, polka band, and concert band. He is the tuba titan, so give it up for Nate. Now, it's tough being, you know, the only person on your instrument, the only person in your section for, you know, 4 years, but Caitlin is definitely a phenomenal oboe player. She's going to Ripon College next year. And I know Dr. Dietrich over there is very, very excited to have you in the ensemble. So Caitlin is our oboe operator. She's been phenomenal. Allie has been a huge part of our band, helping me out with like everything. She was my TA first semester, just helped me get through the first part of the year just with all like the book work, uniforms, music, all that stuff. She's really the heart of the band, and I think you can hear it in her playing. She's phenomenal, and I'm really gonna miss you as well as all these seniors, but Ellie Johansson, the heart of the band. We had some slim years in the trombone section, and thankfully we had a person to kind of keep the trombone culture alive. And this is Ben Johnson, and he is the keeper of trombone culture. If you don't know what it is, well, you'll have to research and look it up on Google and stuff, but very select few know about trombone culture, and Ben's one of them. You can ask him after the concert, but Ben, the keeper of trombone culture. Thank you. This is Eric Kisser. I don't think I need to say too much. I mean, Eric Kisser has been a mainstay of Pep Band for the past 4 years. I don't know what we're gonna do next year actually without you, Eric. He's been essential on lead trumpet, playing the, you know, keeping the whole band alive. He is the Pep Band all-time all-star. So thank you, Eric. Now, percussionists get a bad rap sometimes. You know, they drool back there, they hit stuff, but it can be kind of temperamental. But Caitlin Koval is the exception to that, and just very great person, encouraging, and just brightens my day every time I see her. And for that, she gets the nicest percussionist ever. These kids can probably tell you, I have my own like set of temper and get stressed out like right before we have performances and stuff. And there was a point with trumpet choir, if you guys remember, right before soul ensemble, wasn't sounding too good. And I kind of like gave the business to the upperclassmen, like, you guys gotta help out these younger kids, because I was busy helping out all the other ensembles. And there was one student that stepped up, and I remember like looking out as I quick checked the practice rooms, and there was Leah working with the younger students, and just really just a phenomenal teacher and mentor. And for that, she is the trumpet mentor. This is Julia. She's from Germany. She's been joining us. She's been in our polka band, translating all those German words that I've never known before and telling us a little bit about like cities and polkas and all that stuff. She's been just a great student to get to know and just learn more about different cultures. Julia, for that, you are the ambassador. Thank you very much. Now this guy, I'm really jealous. In a few weeks, he's gonna be going to Florida, Disney World. And this is Calvin. And so normally we would give the letter out that night, but I just want to give this to you tonight because I know you're going to be gone. So there's your letter, which is great. Now, Calvin is a phenomenal student. First started on alto saxophone back in fifth grade, eventually transitioned to drums, and is just a great student, always like keeps the spirit alive, and he is the keeper of the beat. So thank you very much, Calvin. Blade is a man beyond his years. I just really enjoy conversations with you, whether from history to just music. And has informed me a lot about just different classical styles of music. And even, he is an aficionado of early band music repertoire. So we've had great conversations about that stuff. So for that, Blade, you are the music historian. Tanner, you heard take a solo earlier in the Ellington Jazz Band. Wasn't too keen on taking solos at first, but I think, as you could tell, as you could hear earlier tonight, he's just a phenomenal soloist and just a great leader, great saxophone player. Kind of approaches it from more of a technical aspect and just does such a fabulous job. For that, you are the saxophone scientist. Natalie, it's hard to put into words, but as you can tell right now, I know what she's thinking inside, but she's always very straight-faced and usually has either some cynical or ironic remark behind her, but it's all in good fun and always manages to make me laugh and just brighten up my day as well. So Natalie, you are the straight-faced joker. Thank you. Hayden, I don't know what else to say. I mean, you are the saxophone professor. That's all I can say. Sarah, whenever I'm getting a bad idea, usually I can count on Sarah. She's always to my left. I don't know what I'm going to do next year, Sarah, but usually if I'm getting that bad idea in my head, she's like, Mr. Jerbeck. I'm like, okay. For that, Sarah, you are the voice of reason. If you were fortunate enough to hear the jazz ensemble at our district level solo ensemble, you would probably hear one of the greatest introductions ever. Jody has done this time and time again. Just a great public speaker, natural leader. And I'm officially declaring her the band's official spokesperson. So. Ryan, phenomenal student, plays many different saxophones, kind of covers whatever we need. And there was a point there where it didn't quite look like we were going to be able to have two jazz hands because we needed like that lead alto, that person that could, you know, facilitate having that band. And whenever I need Ryan to do something, he jumps in, he'll do it, and does such a phenomenal job. And for that, you are the fearless facilitator. Levi, I was so surprised at the beginning of this year. He took a solo, and it was one of the most funkiest, like, cool, jazzy solos I think I've ever heard. And for that, Levi, you are the funky improviser. All right, we're getting down to the end, I promise. So, Kaylee, you have covered so many different instruments for us, from saxophone and jazz ensemble to alto clarinet, bass clarinet, regular clarinet. You've kind of done it all, so I think it would only be appropriate to memorialize you as the clarinet Swiss Army knife. All right. Now, obviously, all these kids, they've been with me, most of them, since fifth grade, and I've had the honor of getting to know them over the years, and they've had the, I guess, the punishment of hearing all my bad jokes for many, many years, the same jokes kind of over and over again. But I had to enlist the help of the students behind me, the underclassmen, and there's some awards that I need to give out. The first one is the Semper Fidelis Award. It's presented by the Marine Band, and it goes to honor a senior who has demonstrated loyalty, honor, leadership, all those qualities. And the students selected Sarah Trachty for this award. Louis Armstrong Award goes to an outstanding senior in the area of jazz. And this year, the students in jazz ensemble selected Hayden Schultz for this honor. And last but not least, this is the John Philip Sousa Award. It goes to a student who's demonstrated just outstanding musicianship, you know, all the qualities that you look for. And I can honestly say I could pick any one of these seniors and they would win it probably any year. But the students back there helped me decide. I don't want to not take responsibility for this, but I think it goes to a very deserving person who's demonstrated all those qualities. And this year it goes to Gage Katie. I just need to quick put a plug in. Our friends of Winneconne Music and Performing Arts have sponsored a scholarship, so many of you, or all of you, are members. It's just a matter of if you can come to the meetings. It's usually the first Thursday of every month, 4:30 in the high school band room. They have already had their last meeting this year, but if you'd like to join us next year when the school year starts, I'll send you an email, and I'm sure they would love to have you part of their organization. But they sponsor a scholarship for music camps over the summer, and this year it's been awarded to Austin Morris and Brianna Johnson. Would you guys come forward? All right, that's all I got.
Now, you think that's it, Mr. Garrett? Boy, have you got another thing coming.
Garbage thing. Okay, so we always make a senior board every year of all the seniors, so we're going to start off with that. If you've ever been into the band room, you've seen all of the different classes. But this year, we decided to do something a little special. We decided to go with a Star Wars theme. Throughout our years in band, Star Wars has been a pretty constant presence. We've watched the movie trailers, we have quoted Yoda, and we've even played the soundtrack. And Mr. Jarevic even has like a lightsaber baton, and I happen to know the pretty cool dude who made it. It was my brother, for those who don't know. So, without further ado, I'll let you pull it out if I can try my hands. That's what this is.
Cool.
So thank you for making us masters we are today.
Hello, hello, hello. So many of you may know the band and choir took a trip to New York City over spring break this year. It was while we were in New York City that we met a man in Central Park. This man gave us some very deep and inspirational life advice, along with why bubble making would be an appropriate and rewarding career choice for anybody. The bubble man had a simple setup: two sticks, a string, some soap water, and a bucket. It was intriguing, and it almost took up around 10 minutes of our time in Central Park. He told us that he had people all over the country he'd trained performing his craft. Fortunately, Mr. Jarebeck loves his job teaching all of us music, so this will have to be more of a retirement fund or a college fund for the kids. You can be the bubble man of Marble Park, not quite as good as Central Park. So, with that being said, I present to you, Mr. Jarebeck, your very own bucket, sticks, string, and soap water. I think it would be appropriate if you made a bubble for us right now. But he is now the bubble man of Marble Park.
Another thing that has followed us throughout high school is Mr. Jarebeck's love for polka. He started the much acclaimed Zero Hour Polka Band several years ago, and he paid his way through college with the money that he made from polka gigs. Because he's the biggest polka nerd we know, we thought it would be appropriate to give him this.
Oh, I know this is funny. This is funny.
Can we make more of these and put them on sale? People make one more for their own house. It's pretty cool.
Thank you.
Once again, thank you all for coming tonight. We live in such a wonderful country, and I'm so proud of the American music that we have, and this is probably one of the most patriotic, inspirational American pieces of music ever. It's Stars and Stripes Forever by John Philip Sousa. And I would just like to thank a few people really quick. Mr. Tim Phillips back on sound and lights, making us look and sound good tonight, so thank you so much. As well as Stephanie Ron and Mrs. Zemlock, Lisa Zemlock, for helping and co-teaching the jazz ensemble. So those groups would not be possible without them. And the amazing people I work with here at Winneconne High School, as well as our music staff. I see Carl Hall out there, and Abby Schmidt. I don't know if she's here tonight, but I'm very, very lucky. I get to work with the greatest students in the world and the greatest staff. So thank you all for coming here tonight. Without further ado, this is Stars and Stripes Forever.